Drop your pants. Bend over. Bend over, mate. Now hold still.
The Mule is the story of a naive guy who is convinced to mule drugs.
This coercing is done by his old neighbour, Gavin Ellis, played by Leigh Whannell.
Right.
No, it's me.
And his employer, Pat Shepherd, is played by John Noble.
Half a kilo, no more, no less.
Ray is caught at the airport, and so the federal police get a hold of him.
My name is Detective Les Paris. This is Detective Tom Croft.
They suspect that he's got these drugs inside his gut.
In 1983, police weren't allowed to examine you internally or take x-rays of you without the subject's permission.
So they take him to a motel room. He's facing years in jail, his whole life unraveling. He's like, well, if I don't let these drugs fall out of me, they got nothing to charge me with. And so he keeps them inside him.
I've got nothing to hide.
And that decision of Ray's just sets in motion this entire catastrophe of a story and just drags everyone into it.
Bit of hash?
Anyone offer you drugs?
Bit of coke?
No.
Ask you to hide drugs.
Mum like a taste, does she?
These gruff and tumble Melbourne cops in 1983 are faced with a situation they've never been faced with before.
The character I play is Tom Croft. He's a federal cop. His methods are questionable. He's a sexist pig who probably throw a punch quicker than most people. I thought the situation was very funny, but the characters felt real in a particular world at a particular time.
You need to watch your mouth, spoof bag. You are this close to getting run over.
Les Paris is played by Ewen Leslie, a younger, ambitious cop.
I'm not interested in putting away good blokes who've made one bad decision. I want the real bastards.
I just thought it was a wonderful script. All the characters were very clearly defined, and I thought, well, this would be something that would be really exciting to be a part of.
There's a whole sort of net of characters around Ray. His mother, played by Noni Hazlehurst, is sort of a strong, noble woman that looks after him.
Why are you and Gavin knocking around again?
He's got me out of time from work, Mum.
Yeah, well, he's bad news, Ray. He's been in jail.
The amazing Geoff Morrell, who plays Ray's stepfather, John.
What is funny about the Mule, you know, is it's just well-observed human behaviour, you know, and if you've got an eye for what is funny, which these writers obviously do, well, I think it's very understated kind of humour.
Why? Sonia Ung, the drug dealer. How would you describe Sonia?
We're not sure if it's a lady or a man. He sort of acts like both.
And go Bangkok, have no eggs.
And Pat, that Angus mentioned, he has his henchmen. He has Ziggy, who's this, like, huge Lithuanian man mountain. When he gets angry, it's a sight to behold. He comes to my character's house and makes short work of it with a whopping big pickaxe. Into that world steps Jasmine Griffiths, played by Georgina Haig, and she is a young legal aid lawyer who's way out of her depth. She's surrounded by this swarming mass of masculinity.
I think we could have a moment alone.
What, you and me?
Alas, no. Dr. Zaki and I.
So all of these characters kind of swirl around Ray. The story is this hurricane of bad decisions and lies. Ray is at the eye of the hurricane.
I guess the sort of black humour of it is that they're all waiting for him to poo. The thinking is just how could something so little have such huge ramifications?
They're going to do whatever it takes to get the drugs out of their system. They sort of underestimate Ray in various ways.